Hello again, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thanks for tuning in. In today's video, as you can see, we'll be dealing with the topic of the economy and companies, which belongs in Unit 3 of Social Science Class for Year 5. First of all, you know, with your permission, and even without it, I'm going to take off my mask because, like, seriously, nice. Que alivio. I'm on my own in the classroom. All the windows and doors are open. We're getting some draft here, and there is no need for me to wear the mask right now. I'm actually complying with all the safety and regulation and all the rules and stuff. The economy and companies. This actually is consistent with what you're going to find at page 38 of your books, ladies and gentlemen. Page 38 of your books. And what our book says is that the economy is all the activities involved in producing, selling, buying the products and services we require for our basic needs. So needs such as a good education, a good healthcare, for instance, those are part of our basic needs nowadays. There are three main processes that make up the economic activity: production, distribution, and consumption. Understood? Great. So this would be the economy in general terms. We can to look at it like a bit further. Production. This includes all of the activities needed to make a product or provide a service. We're dealing with the so-called means of production right now. You see? So this would mean the actual basics or infrastructure for the rest of the economy system. As regards to distribution, the distribution channels make sure that these products reach us, reach the customer through transportation, etc. Consumption, on the other hand, it relates to the buying and selling of the product to the customers, to the clients, basically to us. A company is an organization which offers products or services to customers in exchange for making a profit. A profit. Yeah? And it says here, a profit is a financial gain. Some companies also provide products or services to help social causes. Claro, mirad, de entrada, so for starters, the company doesn't offer a service out of the kindness of their heart, you know? They need to make a profit economically, financially, okay? Some companies may help social causes, but they do it because of the effects of taxation. Understand? Taxation. Lo hacen, de nuevo, no por motivos realmente humanitarios, cuando ayudan a una causa social, sino porque esto desgrava de cara a Hacienda, de cara a los impuestos que se imponen a la empresa. Y ofrecen un servicio, pretenden obtener un beneficio de tipo económico a cambio, ¿no? Esto se entiende perfectamente. Then, human resources. These are the employees who work for the company. Los recursos humanos son los empleados de la empresa. material resources. These include the raw materials, en las materias primas, to make the product. They also include the machines, transport, and new technologies, etc. The machinery, and the use of computers and the internet. Okay? Financial resources. This is the money that a company needs to carry out its activities. En facto, unos recursos humanos, unos recursos materiales y unos recursos financieros. Y de hecho, estos recursos financieros son la base de todo. Es, de hecho, esto, en points of fact, this is what Karl Marx actually called the infrastructure. And the superstructure would go like on top of it all. Now we're going to look into the different departments. So the first one that we encounter is purchases. This department buys the materials and services the company needs. Production. This department creates the product or service the company sells. Human resources. This department employs and manages the company employees. Marketing. This department creates advertising for products or services. Entonces, fijémonos cómo el departamento de compras, ¿vale?, es el que se encarga de obtener los materiales y determinados servicios que la empresa necesita, ¿vale? Ocurre también en la empresa pública. Habéis visto cómo hay determinado tipo de servicios, el mantenimiento de los ordenadores, de las impresoras, ¿verdad?, que viene gente de fuera a realizarlo. Eso es un servicio que hay que pagarlo, ¿vale? Lo vemos también en el propio colegio, si lo entendemos como empresa educativa, los materiales que utilizamos, ¿vale?, libros, pupitres, etcétera, todo esto cuesta un dinero. Pues esto en una empresa lo lleva a cabo el departamento de compras. El departamento de producción es de hecho el que crea el producto o el servicio, ¿vale?, que la empresa vende. Y hay empresas de producto y empresas de servicios, que las empresas de servicios es principalmente lo que se especializa en España. Los recursos humanos. El departamento de recursos humanos pues es el que se encarga tanto de contratar como de despedir, como etcétera, etcétera, la cuestión, por ejemplo, de las nóminas y tal, cómo se le paga el sueldo a los empleados. Marketing. El departamento de marketing es el que se encarga de publicitar el servicio o el producto que se vende. Last but not least, we've got accounts. This is the department that manages the company's money. El departamento de cuentas sería el departamento que se encarga de manejar, como su propio nombre indica, las cuentas, el dinero, la pasta de la empresa. These companies that we've been talking about may fit into one of these three categories. They may belong into the primary sector, the secondary sector, or tertiary sector. I do invite you to check out my videos explaining a bit further these economic sectors. The primary sector, these companies obtain resources from nature, for example, a mining company. The secondary sector, these companies transform raw materials into products, for example, a furniture company. Over here, we would be talking about the industry as such. The tertiary sector, this is mostly the services sector, okay? These companies provide services, for example, a dentist, surgery, a restaurant, or a shop. Sector primario. Tiene que ver con la obtención de recursos naturales. Sector secundario es la industria propiamente dicha, ¿vale? El transformar esos materiales en productos manufacturados. Y el sector terciario, para que nos entendamos, es el sector servicios. Companies can be different sizes. Small companies have less than 50 employees. Medium companies have from 50 to 250 employees. Large companies have more than 250 employees. As regards of organization of companies, a company is like a giant puzzle made up of different pieces. All the pieces are necessary for the company to work well. These pieces are called departments. And they each have a different function. Managers organize and coordinate the different departments. Entonces, eso, las empresas se dividen en departamentos y cada uno de estos departamentos cumple una función dentro de la propia organización. As you can see on page 39 of our books, the book itself focuses on a final activity, bit of a game, okay? It says here, work with the picks. Se nos propone hacer la página 39 del libro este ejercicio. Work with the picks. Identify these companies from their logos. What products or services do they provide? Which economic sector do they belong to? Buenas preguntas, ¿eh? Son empresas muy conocidas, seguro que ya habéis dado en el clavo todos. So the next time that we see each other, you tell me what these companies are, what products or services they provide, and what economic sector they belong to. Well, thanks for your attention, and I do remind you that later on, other videos will be dealing a bit. Qué cuadrilla de salvajes, Dios mío. I'm among the heathen. I'm among the heathen. So, in later videos, we'll be dealing with some of these specific topics a bit further. And now, I'll put on my face mask and get back home.